I'm Valder Beebe, host of the Valder Beebe Show. I am famously known for That Celebrity Interview, interviews with today's pop icons, movie stars, and celebrities. Tune into our FM radio broadcast and our online broadcast. Visit ValderBeebeShow.com and SoundCloud.com/ValderBeebeShow. I'll see you there.
And Tina Campbell, thank you so much for joining me here on the Valder Beebe Show live in Dallas, Texas on KYBS.
Awesome. Glad to be with you.
Well, I'm glad you guys even have time to talk to people. You're so busy.
We're in the business of people, so it's right? All good.
Well, we know you as Eric and Tina Campbell, but we also know you as Mary Mary.
Yes.
And you guys have so many accolades that are coming up that you've already done. I can't list them all. You've got, between you, you've got new album, you've got new season, you've got a web series, you've got a tour. I mean, you've got so much. And I found out, Erica, you're a preacher's wife, if I'm correct.
I am. We started a church, California Worship Center in North Hollywood, California, and a radio show, a syndicated
radio show.
Yes.
And 40 markets.
You guys are the epitome of the 21st century woman. If I could start with you, Erica, I'm just choosing you because your name is first. You start with an E rather than a T, okay? So you guys don't have to worry about that.
No worries.
It's all good.
Tell me about this six, and it says the final season. Tell me if it's true, the final season.
Absolutely true. This is it. We're wrapping it up. I feel like the sixth season, it's good for us to end here. You've seen so many ups and downs, but in this season, you will see a brand new Mary Mary song, which, you know, in the show they've been asking for the past two seasons. But you'll also see the layers of our lives, that we have other businesses, and our children are growing, our families are growing, and so you have to allow yourself to grow. Can you imagine if Oprah never stopped the Oprah Winfrey Show and started her network? So even though we have a lot, and I'm not saying that we're starting a network and I'm not Oprah, but moving on and growing is, I think, crucial to becoming your best self. And so that's what we want to do. And we are so grateful for everyone that has watched up until this point. And this season will be an interesting ride, as have the past five seasons, and so we're excited about you coming on this ride once again for the last time.
Yeah. Well, Tina, let me ask you, you know, so much of your personal life has played out, both of you on there. How do you guys really do this? How do you let the frailties and the flaws of your life, how do you let them come on screen?
I'm okay with me. I'm confident in my own skin. I'm confident in who God created me to be. I don't let people make me, so I don't let people break me. I don't let the opinions of people make me esteem myself too highly, so I don't let the insults
bring
me down too low. I know that God has given me my platform, and who I am is defined by the fact that I'm His creation, and He's blessed me with all these wonderful things in my life. And if I keep sight of that, I don't care about being embarrassed or being shamed or falling and having to get back up and growing. I don't care about people knowing it. I don't chase their opinions or their views nor their praise. And so it helps me to sustain. So that's kind of how I've been able to do it. And then I don't like to be hostage to secrets or failures or what if somebody finds out and all that. Like, I'm a public figure. Just deal with yourself and then move on. And that's what I've done.
And that's the lesson that she teaches.
Yeah, and
it's
helpful.
You're one tough cookie, Tina. Okay, Erica, let me ask you, this final season, what do you guys want to leave us with? How do you want to be remembered? Because if you go off the air, and even if you start another show, that's a whole new chapter. So what do you want us to know, or what do you want us to remember?
That we are sisters, and we love God. We love what we do. We embrace challenge, and we know that problems come to make us strong. Trials come to make us strong. You can grow from being honest. Don't hold anything hostage. Let it go. And stick together. That's something my mom and dad taught us. You stick with your family. It's your blood. It's your family. Plus, we believe in God. So we believe in forgiveness. And you can allow yourself to grow and to evolve. Now, I was saying to someone else, not only are we sisters, but we're friends. So are our husbands and our children. So we're connected on and off screen, musically and non-musically. So you know, that there you'll never see, oh, I haven't talked to Tina in 20 years. That's never going to happen.
Come on, man.
Speaking of Tina, Tina, you wrote a letter to President Trump, got some backlash. I know you didn't read the hype about it and things like that. Would you change anything if you could now?
Not ever.
You didn't write it to Trump? I ain't wrote no letter to Trump. I wrote an open letter regarding him. I don't retract anything that I said. I comb over every word and I take full responsibility for it. I stand by what I said collectively, as I said in that letter. I do not agree with all of his choices. I don't agree with all of his decisions. And I had some concerns about him as the president. But since he is in that office, it's my job as a Christian, as a responsible person, to pray for him and not use my platform to bash him and to help fear and worry and those things. And so some of the things that I was hearing in churches across the country was so saddening to me. Everybody was, what are we going to do? And everybody's
like
so
afraid
scared.
And like the world's going to come
to
the
end. All the everybody that's an African-American or Mexican, what is going to, are all lives are going to hell in a handbag? And so I just felt the need to address it like, you guys, you pray for the guy and you stand and pray that God would send the right people that can influence him and help him to make better decisions. But our lives are not coming to an end because he's the president. We don't put our faith in him. We put our faith in God, and we should pray for him because that's what God requires of us. Bashing never helps anything.
We'll still be America once he's not in office anymore.
That's true. Your final season is going to be phenomenal. And I hope, you know, we see the best of you guys, and I hope we see more about your faith and God and things that will inspire the world, because the world can be inspired by two beautiful, talented 21st century women who are doing it all. I want to thank you for being my guest on the Valder Beebe Show. I can't wait for the new season. Tell me when it starts.
It starts on Thursday the 28th at 9 p.m. Thank you so much for having us on WEtv.
And on WEtv. Yes, you're welcome.
Ma'am.
We'll be there. Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome. Bye-bye.